lurking under this whole whether or not you have free will question is a what is you question.
Yeah.
Yes, right. Okay, so Professor, who are you? Like, what defines you?
That one is totally challenging. And it speaks to like the most appealing, most intuitive versions of it, which is that, yeah, there's all these neurons and enzymes and transcription factors and stuff inside your head. But somehow separate of that, there is a me. There's a me. There is the most radical sort of, you know, dualism going on there imaginable, that there is a me that's in your brain, but not of it. And like when the going gets tough, that's the part that's in charge. It's incredibly difficult to simultaneously say, yes, there has emerged from all of that, this thing, this conscious awareness of this thing I call me.
Mm-hmm.
And at the same time, like, I know about neurotransmitters. At the same time, we are not only biological machines, but we are biological machines that can know that we are biological machines and understand where emotions come from and things of that sort. So that, you know, you got to deal on both levels. Like, I am vastly in love with my wife, and I know at the same time, it's got something to do with what variants of like oxytocin receptors I had in my brain and olfactory receptors and my upbringing and all of that. And ooh, does that destroy the feelings of the former because it has a mechanism? Not in the slightest. You, like, you know, some gazelle does something amazing and it leaps 20 feet in the air. And like a biomechanics nerd could explain exactly which fulcrum is responsible for doing that. And you could reduce them to a bunch of equations. And it is no less amazing to see that a gazelle can do that. Like, we could function on multiple levels. And we have to recognize that our me-ness is merely the end product of all that stuff comes before. But nonetheless, that me can still feel the mechanistic phenomenon of pain, so much so that it feels real. And, you know, we have to function on both levels. But again, that's not easy. We're the only species that knows our machineness. Not only do we know our own mortality, we know that there's gears underneath.
This sounds like you're not a dualist.
Oh, no, I am not.
So does that mean you're a monist or non-dualist or...
Oh, God, you've forced me in terrain where, like, the semantics have left me way behind. That's out of my pay grade to choose that. I just don't think there's a me that's not made out of biological, squishy, yucky stuff.
Okay. Well, the reason I say that is that there's a mathematician named Raymond Smullyan, an incredibly playful mathematician. He died, unfortunately, about 10, 20 years ago or so. I'll get the exact data, put it on screen. But anyway, he had this dialogue between a man and God, and it was just his own prose. And it was a man saying to God, arguing, why did you give me free will? Why did you make me responsible? Like, that makes you responsible, God, because you put this onus on me. And then God was saying, well, do you want me to take away your free will? You may go raping and pillaging. And then the guy's like, well, if I do that, then aren't I now morally responsible for what I do in the future? Because I am understanding of that. So I'm upset with you for even giving me this choice, God. And they go on and on and on. Toward the end, God says to the man, you say you're determined. Like, they have this argument about whether or not free will exists and what is it. God says to the man, you say you're determined by the laws of physics, as if you're this creature pushing up this rock of the laws of physics, but the laws of physics are just so much more larger than you, you can't, and so it always wins. But in order for you to say that, you would have to say what separates you from the rock. So you would have to draw a distinction between you and the laws of physics. The reason I bring this up is this has to do with identity. So if we're not able to say what the we is that's separate, this is why I used the word monist earlier, the we is that's separate from the laws of physics, then how can we even say that the laws of physics determine us when there is no difference between us and the laws of physics?
Whoa. Well, that's a complicated question. I think, this is not just sleight of hand, but I think somewhere in there, you're going to have to subtract God out of this picture. Assume a square wheel as sort of a starting point there. I think that makes for a lot of inherent contradictions, which were the type swirling around in my head back when I was 14. I think invoking that, even invoking a God of limited means, God can do anything that is doable. God can't make a boulder that's too heavy for God to pick up. God can't sin, all of that. Even within that framework of sort of Aquinas, still, if you got God in there, it's not going to work.
Let's forget about God, because the dialogue wasn't an argument for God. The dialogue was more like in Douglas Hofstadter, where you have someone who's somewhat of a fool, and then there's a wise person who knows more and is challenging the fool. It's something like that. So it doesn't make a difference if it was God or Goff.
Okay, make that argument in a God-free way then, and let me see what I can do with it.
Well, Goff is saying to you, like, hey, what separates you from the laws of physics? Like, if you're a monist, if you're not a dualist, unless you're a trialist, like a quadrupleist or something else, unless you're that, unless you go upward rather than downward, collapsing to monism or non-dualism, then what separates you from the laws of physics in order for you to say that you're even determined by them and not the same as them or an expression of them?
Maybe stated that way, yes. We're just an expression of them. They play out on a level that causes emergence of properties that include things like consciousness, and I sure as hell can't define it beyond that. So that gives you all sorts of properties that can't be described at the more reductive level.
Sir, just quickly, even to use the term like take the laws of physics or take the neurotransmitters, the word take there implies the separation, which is what's being questioned here. So it's begging the question.
Yeah. Maybe another way, I may not be appreciating sort of the subtleties of sort of the philosophical difference, but at least it strikes me that maybe there is no difference. We're just manifestations of the physics rather than separate entities that are determined by it.
Oh, well, that's super interesting.
That may just be my being a physics troglodyte. That may not have any insight into it at all, but I'm not seeing a difference there.
If you enjoyed that clip, then the full podcast is out right now. You can click around here. Enjoy. Subscribe to Theories of Everything to get notified of upcoming podcasts, as there are new full-length podcasts every week on the topics of mathematics, physics, consciousness, free will, and AI.